Hi everyone, welcome you all. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up Protractor project in Visual Studio Code. So basically Visual Studio Code is an IDE where we can write our Protractor test cases and we can execute them. Now, let us see how we can set up Protractor project in Visual Studio Code. So as a first step, we need to download and install Visual Studio Code editor. So we can download from this location. Let me open this location. And this is the official website of visualstudiocode.com. And here, the Visual Studio is available on Windows as well as Mac and other operating system. And if you're working on Windows, you can just download this installer. Depends upon your chipset, like 64-bit or 32-bit. And if you're working on Mac or other operating system, you can just use these options. So once you download this Visual Studio Code and software, you will get an exe file. Just you need to click on the exe file installer and it will go through certain steps and you will able to install Visual Studio Code. So that's pretty simple and easy steps you can follow. So once you have installed Visual Studio Code and then you have to launch your Visual Studio Code editor. So I already installed my Visual Studio Code. So here it is. So I need to just click on this icon. So which will start opening Visual Studio Code. Now let me open this. Just I'm double clicking on this icon. So which is open Visual Studio Code, and first time when you open this Visual Studio Code, you will see the welcome window. And if you don't see this welcome window, you can just go to the help menu and you can just click on the welcome, then you will see welcome window. So here you can change the themes also. We can change theme as like dark and white. You can just go to the color theme and you can find whichever theme you want. So currently I have selected dark Visual Studio theme, and if you want to go with the white color, you can just go and light Visual Studio like this. So this is another theme. So currently I'm using a dark theme. Just go to color theme and I'm just selecting dark default Visual Studio dark, right? So once you get this Visual Studio Code, right? So the first thing is, after installation of this Visual Studio, the second step is we need to open the Visual Studio Code. So we already opened. Now, the second step is we need to install JavaScript and TypeScript plugins on Visual Studio. So that is another step. So step two is we need to open the Visual Studio Code. And after opening this Visual Studio Code, then we have to install support for JavaScript and TypeScript. Now, let me just write the steps here. Step three, install support for JavaScript and TypeScript. So basically, Protractor is implemented by using JavaScript on Node.js and which is also using TypeScript. So we need support of JavaScript as well as TypeScript. So these two plugins we have to install on Visual Studio Code. So for that, what you have to do is in the welcome screen, you can see the options like this. Let's say tools and languages. Here it is saying install support for JavaScript, Python, PHP, Azure, Docker, and more. So here we need JavaScript and TypeScript support. So by default, I already installed JavaScript support. So it is not in a blue color. And we need to also install TypeScript. Okay, so or you just click on the more here and then it will list out what are all plugins which you already installed. So if you just go and select the JavaScript, which is I already installed. If I just search for JavaScript, so it's just say enter and JavaScript. So I already installed JavaScript, so it is not listing out and it is it's not coming in blue color here. So similarly, we need to also install TypeScript. So let's say TypeScript, search for TypeScript. And in the TypeScript hero, so this is a new plugin which is introduced in Visual Studio Code. And this is also already installed, so it is not giving any install option, right? So just click on the JavaScript here and it will start installing plugin. After that, if TypeScript also displayed in this list, you can just click on the TypeScript, then the TypeScript support also will be installed. And if you don't find these two plugins here, click on the more option and search for JavaScript and TypeScript in the in the text box. And it will show you all the plugins and go and select proper TypeScript or JavaScript plugins. I can just install them. Click on install, it will automatically install in your Visual Studio Code. So that's the next step. So we need to install support for JavaScript and TypeScript. So once we have done this, now we need to set up our project to write our Protractor test cases. So for that, what you have to do is we need to create a new folder in Visual Studio Code Explorer. So let me do this. Let's go to Visual Studio. So I already installed TypeScript and JavaScript so that you can just close this window. We don't need, and just go to Explorer. And in the Explorer, you don't see any folders by default. So we need to create our own folder structure, right? So here, how we can create a new folder is, we need to just go to wherever you want to create your project folder, you can create. So normally I'll create in the documents. In the documents, I'll just create a new folder and I will name it as Protractor Demos. So now I created a new folder, and this folder I need to open in the Visual Studio Code. So you can just click on open folder and browse it, or you can just drag and drop like this. So once you drag and drop, now the same folder is appeared in the Visual Studio Code, and you can just close this welcome window. All right. So now I created a new folder. So that is Protractor Demos. So under this, I will create two subfolders, and one folder will have a config file. The other folder I will maintain the test cases. So let's create a new folder. Here it is an icon which is saying new file, and the second one is a new folder. Third one is just a refreshing explorer, and the next one is just collapsing. So now let me create a new folder under Protractor Demos, and I will name it as a conf folder, and then I will create one more folder, new folder, and I will name it as test cases. So two folders I created, one is conf, the other one is test cases. Now in the previous video I have shown you, right? So basically the protractor is provided all the protractor related modules in the example folder. So let me just open that location. So wherever the protractor is installed, so this is the location. If you just go and open this location, under users, admin, app data, roaming, npm, and node modules, protractor and example. So protractor is given one example by default here, right? So in the previous video, I have shown you these two files. So we have this example spec.js is a specification file where we can write our protractor test case. And to run this test case, we have to specify the path of this JS file inside the conf.js, right? We have seen this. So now what I'm going to do is I just copy these two files inside my folder structure. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I just select this conf inside this folder. I'm just to drag and drop this conf.js. Right. So now conf.js is a part of conf folder. And similarly, currently I don't have any test cases. So example spec.js is a basic test case they have given as a demo. Just I'm copying inside the test cases. Done. So now after that, you can just close this protractor folder. We no need. Now you can see inside the conf folder, I can see conf.js, and this is configuration file they have provided by default. And under test cases folder, I kept example spec.js. This is basically test case file, right? Now let us understand conf.js. So as we discussed in the previous video, so which contains a few more options, like the first option is representing export.config direct connect.to. So this is parameter which is representing our web driver manager is by default will start whenever I start protractor. So you don't need to start web driver manager manually. So this command is representing that. The second one is capabilities. So here we can specify the browser name on which browser we want to execute our test cases. And the next one is a framework. So by default protractor will internally use Jasmine framework. And here, this is the location where we have to specify the test cases. So this is my first test, and example.spec.js I'm running here. So I just specify the name. But suppose this file is present in some other folder. So currently the example spec.js is present in conf folder. So we need to specify the location correctly. So we can specify, just right click on this and get the relative path. You can just see copy relative path and then specify here. Then it will get you relative path, not conf.js, example spec.js. Copy this relative path and then specify here. So previously both are there in the same folder. So now I've separated these two files in separate folders. In the test cases, I have example spec and conf folder, conf.js is there. So this is my conf.js file where we need to specify the where exactly our spec file is present. Done. So now we have configuration file conf.js, and we have a demo test case which is provided by protractor. Done. So this is basic setup. In future, if you want to create multiple test cases or spec files, we have to create under test cases, and those specification files, if you want to run, and go to conf.js and here specify the location of the spec file. And finally, we have to run conf.js file. We have to run conf.js file. So we already installed JavaScript and TypeScript plugins, which are mandatorily required to run your protracted test cases. Done. So in the next step, what we have done, and after fourth step, we have created two folders. That one is conf folder, the other one is test cases folder inside the Protractor demo project. Now, after that, we have copied the two files. So what are those two files we have copied? So let me just go back again here. And in this node modules, Protractor is installed inside this example. Conf and example is provided. So I copied these two under into different folders in our Visual Studio Code. So that's the thing I have done. So that's the next step. So step six is we have copied all the files into from this location. This is the location where all our example files are present. So I just copied them. So conf folder, conf.js into conf folder in Visual Studio Code, and example spec.js into test cases folder. This is our test cases folder in Visual Studio Code. And once you copied, then we can run our conf.js. And we already updated the location also, wherever my spec file is present. So we have to update the location. That's the next step. And in conf.js, update location of spec file. And then we are ready to run our JS file. So let's see how we can run our JS file. So to run our JS file, spec file, we can just go to open the new terminal, go to terminal and new terminal. So here it will show you the new terminal. And here we have to run the command called Protractor. So first of all, where we have this file conf.js present inside the conf folder. So here give one command called protractor space and get the location of conf.js. Copy the relative path of conf.js and then specify here. So conf.js is present inside the conf folder, right? So once you run this particular file, this conf.js internally execute this spec file and it will perform the operations or actions on the web browser. So now let me execute, press enter. So now we can see it is launching my Chrome browser using Chrome driver directly. Now it is launched my Chrome browser, started, and it is saying no specs found. So what does that mean is whatever path we have given here, it is not picking up that path properly, right? That's the reason it is saying no specs found. Now let it correct this path. So what I can do is here test cases slash example underscore spec dot js is there. So let me just capture this path once again, copy relative path and use a forward slash, okay, and save it, then execute once again. I'm just clear and run the same command once again. So it is using Chrome driver directly and it is launching my browser. So still it is saying no spec found. Okay, so let's cross check the location once again. All right, so in the specification file, so here we need to say dot dot slash slash. So these are forward slashes and dot dot representing your current project. Now this conf.js will able to pick this particular spec file and which will able to run. Now let me run once again protractor, and here conf is a folder inside this conf.js file is present. Now let me run this file. So once it is running, now it is launched my browser, which is my Chrome browser, and launching my URL of application. Now it is trying to execute my test case. It's a sample test case, which is provided by Protractor. Done. So you can see here, there are one spec which contains the t-test and which is finished, and it is again passed here. So Chrome 1 test is passed. So three dots means there are three different tests we have inside the file. So that is example spec.js. Okay, so this is how we can set up a Protractor project in Visual Studio Code. And here we have to just create a two folders, conf and test cases. Inside the conf, we have to have a configuration file. Under test cases, we can create multiple spec file. Here test case is nothing but a spec file. So that is a now step. So in the conf.js, update the location of the specification file. And finally, in the last step, we have to run the conf.js in protractor. So command is, in the terminal we have to say protractor conf.js. This is a command we have to execute through terminal. Okay, so this is how we need to set up protractor project in Visual Studio Code. So that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.